Jesus. He is coming. He's going to come in a day when folks are not looking. It's going to be a surprise, like a thief when he breaks in your house. He's not going to be as a thief, but he's going to be coming like a thief. Nobody's going to know when he's going to come. If a man tells you he's going to come, you can almost put it down your book. He ain't coming that day. That won't happen. Jesus is coming, and he's going to come back to rapture us. Now, seeing that we in this time, that we in a time where there's going to be a rapture, and there's going to be a catching away of people that know Jesus Christ, and no doubt it's going to happen, what should we be living like? How should we be walking every day? Well, the world's looking for role models. If you're a businessman, you're going to look. If you are working in a specific field, if you're a teacher, if you're an engineer, if you're a banker, if you're a lawyer, you're going to be looking at people who are successful in that field, and they're going to be your role model. If you're a student and you're in junior high, you're in high school, 9th grade, 10th grade, you're going to be looking at successful 12th graders, and you're going to be looking for a role model, right? And if you're a church, you're going to be looking for a church that if you want to pattern yourself off of another church, you're going to be looking at another church saying, hey, that church is successful. They're running the business right, and the folks there are successful in life. They're having a quality of life, and they're loving God, and their children are being successful. I mean, they're raising them up in church, and their children are being having modern success, you know. And, hey, I want to model off that church or those people. They're having success in their life. And we call those role models or people that we want to be like. Now, if I was to pick a role model in the Bible, I'd look at the heroes of faith. I'd start with Abel, and I'd go all the way down through there with some of the folks that were cut in two and martyrs and all those folks that were heroes of faith. They walked by faith. They couldn't see it, but they knew that he had framed it. And they knew that he was and that he is. The definition of the word faith, something that you can't see. We walk by faith, not by sight. Something we know, we see the world frame, but we don't see the man who framed it. We know God framed it. We're walking by faith. So if I was to look at the time we're in right now with things going on, with the foreshadows and the four types of the Antichrist really showing up right now in the world, and I can tell you this, no doubt, there are foreshadows. And there are types of the Antichrist spirit now, clear and present. And I have a warning for y'all this morning. I can't tell you the day, but he's coming. And judgment is coming to this earth. And I want to preach to you this morning about a role model for you to pattern off of and what you should be doing. When you leave here this morning, you're going to leave here with clear instructions. You won't be confused, and you're going to know just what you need to be doing. We need clarity, and we need understanding, and we need to rightly divide the word of truth, so we're going to know how to walk. Now, the Bible gives us a clear example of a rapture-type figure who walked by faith, and we'd have to go back in the antediluvian years before the flood, around 2,000 years before the flood came and Noah built an ark. Matter of fact, it was Noah's great-grandfather. His name was Enoch. And the Bible says, if you look with me in the chapter 5, book of Genesis, the Bible says that he walked 65 years and he had a son named Methuselah. If you'll look over there in verse 21, chapter 5, you'll look and see that in the book of Genesis. And look in verse 21. The Bible says he lived 65 years, and he begat a son named Methuselah. All of you know who Methuselah is, don't you? He lived how many years? 969 years. He was the oldest recorded man that lived the longest. 969 years. A long time to live, isn't it? Well, if you'd read the genealogies of these folks here, some of them lived 600, 700, 800, 900 years. They lived a long time. One of the reasons being that it was a pink light that came on the earth, what folks say, and it was a quality of life, and they didn't have all the cancers, and the earth didn't have all the diseases in it with all the fruits and vegetables that we have today, and And it was a time when the earth was fresh from the fall. And it was a time where men were young in history. But there was a role model. There was a hero of faith that we need to look at, because he is a prefigure of what's fixing to happen, what's going to happen. We're going to be raptured. And I need a role model, don't you? I need to look at some figure that was raptured so I can look to him and say, hey, I want to walk just like he walked. Now, the Bible tells us some things about Enoch, and we're going to look at it, and it's very clear. He was a hero of faith, and the word Enoch itself means narrow. And he lived it. He was narrow-minded. Why? I'm going to show you in a few minutes how he was narrow-minded. And some folks say, well, they lived in caves and they were trying to discover fire and stuff. And these archaic people, we can't learn anything from them. I don't believe that. That secular history that being taught is a bunch of garbage. Our forefathers, our ancestors that were first created, they knew a lot of things. They knew about the constellations. They were farmers. They were herdsmen. They knew how to plow. They knew how to plant. I didn't come from some caveman. Matter of fact, we have actually lost down our intelligence. Those men before the flood were very intelligent. Adam was super intelligent. He could name every animal on planet Earth and call their names the next day. If you talk to me sometime I have three sons, Ryan, Rory, and Renard, and they'll be talking to them, and I'll call one of them Renard and one of them Ryan, and I'll be talking to Rory. And boy, you know the jealousy that runs in families today? You know, if you call one of your sons some their brother's name, you like him better than you like me. And don't y'all tell him I said that. And cut that off that recorder. But it happens. And I got fine sons. Don't get me wrong, but that's just human nature. Amen? Anyway, here we have a man that to me is a role model, and that's Enoch. And the word Enoch means narrow-minded. He lived up to his name. I want you to know that. And if you look in the Bible, you can tell how he lived up to his name. Matter of fact, the scripture says that when he had Methuselah, he had Methuselah, in verse 21, he began to walk with God, verse 22. And Enoch walked with God after he was 65 years old. He began to walk with God. And I want you to look at verse 22. How many years? 300 years. Can you imagine that? Here's a man that walked every day with God. If he was living in modern America today, I believe he would go to church. He might even be a preacher or a teacher. He'd be a student of the Word of God, I guarantee you. He'd study the Bible every day, I guarantee you. He would not mince what he believed in. And something else about Methuselah, he wouldn't be very popular. Because he was narrow. He would not conform to the image of the world. He walked with God. Now, I want you to think about the importance of this message this morning. Very important to you. Well, I'll not say it's the most important message that I've preached to you since I've been here at this church, but it's one of the most important messages, because it tells us about a man that was actually raptured, and he is a type of what is going to happen. And I believe, and I'm not Mr. Camping, I believe it's going to happen very soon. Amen. I don't think we're going to have another 1,000 years. Now, we could. We don't know the day or the hour, but we know the generation. We know the signs, and I believe all the signs are present. And I believe Jesus is coming soon. And I believe there's going to be a rapture soon. So what I've chosen, the Spirit that's working in me since what's been happening, the Spirit that's working in me is to tell me, hey, I need to find a role model that I can pattern my life after so I can go when that trump sounds. Are y'all listening this morning? Now, we can come in here and be religious today and look religious and go through the calisthenics of religion, but let me tell you something. What's going to matter most is that we're ready and we prepared ourselves. Now, I want to get y'all ready this morning, and we're going to look at this role model, and we want to be ready. Y'all want to be ready? When that trump sounds, I want to go. Don't you want to go? I want to be the first one out here in a twinkling of an eye. I don't think it's going to go in order, but I think we're all going to go at one time. Twinkling of an eye. That's quick, isn't it? Bat your eye. Already gone. So we need to be prepared. We need to make ourselves ready. And I think we should be watching. Jesus said, do what? Watch, for you know not the hour when he comes. I believe we should be watching. And this morning, I think it's an urgency to be watching, because the pattern of the things that's happening all over the world is so clear and present that he's coming. And guys like Mr. Camper, who got all these folks to follow him and quit working for a week and quit taking baths and quit paying their bills and running up charge cards and driving thousands of miles, that's not going to happen to you if you'll listen to me this morning. There's one thing you need to do, walk with God. Enoch walked with God 300 years. Now, to get an idea of how long that might be, think back to 1711. America's about 300 years old. From 1711 to 2011 is 300 years. That's how long Enoch walked with God. He didn't get discouraged. He didn't quit. He walked with God. You might say, well, Brother Dan, there's a lot of folks been saved. And there's a lot of folks joined this church, and they're not here today. I'm going to tell you why they're not here today. They're not walking with God. If you walk with God, you're going to show up, and you're going to pray, and you're going to read your Bible, and you're going to support whatever God's doing, and you're going to walk with God. What does it mean to walk with God? That means I'm in tune with God. I'm listening to God, and I want to do his will. Jesus had a testimony. What was it? That he did what? He pleased who? God. We should have a testimony that we please who? God. Hey, whatever God wants, I want to do it. That's walking with God. Whatever's in the book, that's what I want to do. I want to walk with God. Enoch was narrow-minded. Why? Because he preached judgment. He preached what was going to come on this earth. It hadn't happened yet, but he preached judgment. What did he preach, Brother Danny? He preached that God was going to come back with 10,000 of his saints and that he was going to execute judgment on this earth. He was saying that before the flood. He was talking about an apocalyptic event that's going to happen to the earth. There's going to be judgment in the earth. Jesus talked about it. He said there'd be a time when there was, and John talked about it on Isle of Patmos. There's be a time on planet earth that's never been like it since the time that Adam was created. There's going to be judgment come to this earth. The old world was destroyed by water, but the world that we live in today, there's going to be fire, and there's going to be earthquakes, and there's going to be famine, and there's going to be pestilences, and there's going to be war, and there's going to be rumors of war. And right now, we're in the edge of that. And if you can't see that, you haven't been reading your newspaper, or you're not aware what's going on in the world, but the world's in trouble, and we are under judgment. Amen. Earthquakes, volcanoes, numerous, happening more frequently. That's what Jesus was talking about. There's always been earthquakes. There's always been floods. There's always been tornadoes. There's always been those things. But it's increasing today, and it's more today, frequently, than it's ever been in past history. Jesus is coming. We need a role model. What's that role model? Enoch. Enoch was taken out of here. And we're going to be taken out of here. Enoch is a type of what's going to happen to us. Amen. He walked with God 300 years, and he pleased God. He pleased God so much that God reached down and picked him up by the hair of the head and yanked him right out of here. And he's going to do us the same way. Jesus is coming. Amen. Look in your Bible. How do you know these things? Well, the Bible tells us. He had Methuselah after 65 years, for 300 years after he had Methuselah, verse 24, and Enoch walked with God 300 years, and he was not. He was not on this earth anymore. Can I say to you this morning, we're not going to be here on this earth one day. We're going to be out of here. We're going to go be with Jesus. We're going to go to heaven. And Methuselah lived 187 years and begat Lamech. Now, most of you know who Lamech's grandson is or was. And it was who? Her son, Noah. And, of course, I won't tell you how bad things were. Lamech's son Noah. And I won't tell you how bad things were. The Bible says that there was giants in the land, that there was wickedness in the land, and men were so wicked that their mind was their imagination was on wicked continually. There were murderers. They were having all kind of promiscuous sexual things going on. They were
They were worshiping Satan. They were having angel worship, and the sons of men were actually having all kind of weird things going on, and the sons of flesh were just having a weird situation where the actual seed of men was being destroyed. All flesh had been corrupted, and they were always murdering. They were killing. They were lying. They were cheating. And the big thing was, it was all about sexual perversion in that day. But Noah was different. Y'all listening to me? Noah didn't have the pornography. Noah didn't have the beer. He didn't have the alcohol. Noah didn't walk with the men of this world. Listen very close to me. Listen very close. When dirty jokes were being told, Noah walked away. I don't hear that. When things that didn't please God, he walked away. What does it mean? He walked with God. He made a distinction. There was a difference. Now, I'm going to tell you what. He didn't have a lot of friends in that day either. None. He walked away from it. He walked with God. He did not please men, but he pleased God. There's one thing you can say about Enoch, that he pleased God. He didn't walk with this world. He was narrow. He had a difference. Now, let me tell you something. I want y'all to listen close to me. It's going to make a difference. He was a man of faith. He believed in the one that was coming. He believed that God was going to judge this earth because of sin. And he gave that message out. He preached that message. Y'all listen very close to me. He preached that message that God was a holy, righteous God and that he would execute judgment on this earth. And to make yourself ready, he walked with God. He said, my home's in heaven. I serve a God. I know he formed this earth. I believe God made every bit of this, and I'm going to walk with God. Let me tell you something. It's important this morning that you have a walk with God. It's going to make all the difference when the trump sounds. There are going to be many folks left on this earth, a lot of folks sitting in church who do not walk with God, who do not trust Christ. They're walking with this world. They've conformed themselves with this world. And when the rapture comes, they're going to be left in this world. Let me tell you something. They're going to be left in this world. I don't want to be different. I want to be conformed to this world. I want people to be accepted. I want to be accepted of men and women in this world. If you have that thought, if you have that mind, you're not walking with God. Because God's a holy, righteous God. And there are going to be a lot of folks left on this planet when the rapture happens. And you can't tell me this morning, if you love Jesus Christ, you're going to walk like the world walks today. You're going to walk differently. Amen. Your steps are going to be ordered completely different. That's right. Enoch had that testimony that he walked with God not 10 years, not 5 years, not 20 years, not 60 years, but 300 years he pleased God. Every day he pleased God. God, I love you. God, I want you. God, I'm serving you. You are the one true God. And he told all his neighbors, said, look, God's coming and he's going to judge this earth. How do you know that, Brother Dan? How do you know he preached that message? Because the Bible says it. Where do you see that in the Bible? Where in the world do you see that he preached that type of message? Would you really like to know this morning? Would you really like to look? He evidently lived up to his name. Let me tell you what, God's not interested in religious folks this morning. Clean your ears up a little bit. God's not interested in our religion this morning. He's interested in men and women that love him. Amen. Y'all got it? God's interested in men and women that say, God, I just want to please you. I want to serve you. I want to walk with you. And I want it to be said that I serve you. Now look with me in Jude, if you don't mind. And let me share with you what Saint Enoch preached and what he taught. You mean to tell me, Brother Danny, that's in the Bible, what he preached? Yeah. Look in Jude 14, 15, verse 14, 15. For all of you that are wondering, those of you that are wondering, how many chapters in the book of Jude? Well, there's only one chapter. So when I say verse 14, that means two verses, verse 14, verse 15. Yeah, all you got to do is turn to the book of Jude. You don't have to thumb through it and look for chapter 2, chapter 3. It's only one chapter. Read your Bible sometime. You'll find that out. Jude, verse 14, verse 15. And Enoch, look what it said about Enoch. Here's my role model. He knew prophecy. Well, I don't like prophecy. I don't understand those things. Well, you might be interested in looking at it a little bit. Jesus is coming. There's coming judgment on the earth. That's what Enoch was saying 6,000 years ago. Wow. Here's my role models saying the judgment's coming on. You know what? If preachers go to preaching that today, folks are going to get mad at them. Brother Danny, God's got love. Yeah, he is got love. He's the only man that really loved us truly. Why? Because he died for me. Nobody else ever died for me. He became a curse for me. What do you mean he became a curse for me? A man that was crucified on a cross, on a tree, meant a curse. A symbol of a cross, our religious symbol, cross. What does that mean to us? That means that the perfect man died on the cross. He died a heinous punishment that you and I might be saved. He took our punishment. Jesus Christ was perfect. He loved us perfect. I don't love you perfect. Jesus loves you perfect. I can't love you perfect. Jesus loves you perfect. He is God of love. Perfect love casteth out fear. That's what that means. I don't have no fear of judgment because he loved me perfectly. Most folks don't understand that in the modern church today. Haven't been taught. He shed his blood. That's archaic teaching. They don't teach that anymore. Don't teach about blood being shed. That's archaic. That's cruel. That's sadistic. Well, he loved me perfect because he had to pay my sin debt. Enoch realized that. Enoch preached it, that there was judgment coming, and by faith he believed in God. Look what he says in verse 14. In verse 15 of the book of Jude, and Enoch also, the seventh from Adam, prophesied of these, saying, behold, the Lord cometh with 10,000 of his saints. And he was so narrow-minded, poor Enoch. This word Enoch means narrow-minded. Look what he said, to do what? To execute judgment. Wait a minute, preacher. You're supposed to be preaching things to make me feel good this morning. Well, I'm going to give you something to make you feel good this morning. I'm going to show you a role model to pattern your life after. And that's Mr. Enoch. Keep walking with God. Well, preacher, I think I'm going to quit church. A lot of folks have. I baptize a lot of folks here. A lot of them not here. Some may be in other churches. I don't know. I don't know, but they're not here. I presume that they're not. We check every week, have the join of the churches. None join of the churches. I don't know. I believe a lot of folks just quit walking with God. Let me tell you something, how I believe this. I believe if you love Jesus and you realize who you are in Christ and what he did at the cross, that when you get up on Sunday morning, if you're not in the house of God, you're going to feel miserable inside. Amen. Somewhere. Amen. You may not be here, but you're going to be somewhere. Amen. You just can't sit home while the preaching of the gospel is going on. You want to go find it, don't you? You want to go hear the word preached and taught. And you want to fellowship with other saints. And you want to be a part of what God's doing.